Hello everyone. In this presentation, we are going to see about a simplified, probably the most easiest technique of obturating the root canal system in those situations where we need to place a post inside the root canal space. So whenever we are planning to place a post and to do a post and core restoration, this may be considered as the easiest or maybe the simplest technique even for a beginner to perform. This was one of the common techniques which was practiced a lot in the past, but after the advancements in the thermoplasticized obturation system, slowly this technique was forgotten. But after the introduction of bioceramic sealers, this technique is again getting its popularity because of the better seal which can be provided by the bioceramic sealers. When we are looking into the root canal obturation, the apical 3 to 5 millimeters of the obturation provides the seal from the apical leakage, which can be considered to be the most important part in root canal obturation, because this apical portion of the root canal obturation will have the apical fins, grooves, lateral canals, accessory canals, and all those abnormalities and imperfections in the root canal are present in this 3 to 5 mm. If we are doing a perfect obturation of this 3 to 5 millimeters in the apical end of the root canal system, we can obviously consider that this root canal system obturated is good and it is going to be successful. It is not always mandatory that it should be 5 millimeter. If it is better than 5 millimeters, it is always well and good. But the minimum length of the apical third obturation should be at least 5 millimeters. Now I am going to explain an easy technique which can be practiced and performed even by a beginner. Just carefully observe the technique and try to do it in extracted teeth and maybe in models, and so that you will become master in this technique. After cleaning and shaping, as like with any other obturation system, we have to select a master cone. This master cone must be verified in a radiograph and the apical extent have to be checked. Also, a good tuck back of the master cone is essential and it will provide a better apical seal. Once that is selected, we have to choose a finger plugger of appropriate size. Make sure that the finger plugger is placed inside the root canal system approximately 5 mm short from the radiographic working length. Fit the stopper in the plugger at this level and take a radiograph. Once this is done, take the selected master cone and measure exactly 5 millimeters, and with the help of a scissors or a BP blade, cut exactly 5 millimeters. So now we have got the cut portion of the master cone and also the selected plugger. Now take a spirit lamp or use any heat source and just heat the tip of the plugger over the heat source. Once the plugger is hot, take the plugger and gently touch the cut portion of the selected master cone. Keep this aside. With the help of a Lindelof spiral with another master cone or with a spreader, apply bioceramic sealer inside the root canal system. Make sure that it is applied and it is extending up to the apical third. Then take the plugger attached to the gutta percha and spread it over the bioceramic sealer and place it inside the prepared root canal system. Make sure that it is placed and the stopper in the plugger come in contact with the standard reference point that you have already set up. Once this is done, just give a counterclockwise twist and remove the plugger which is attached to the gutta percha. Once this is done, we can use the plugger again to pack it completely and check in a radiograph whether the sectional obturation that you have done is complete. All might ask, is it not possible to do the sectional obturation with any other root canal sealers? Obviously, we can do with any other root canal sealers, but with the help of the bioceramic sealers, the seal which is provided will be much better. It is a bioactive, biocompatible material, and also the penetration of the sealer inside these lateral canals, fins and the accessories are much better. It also has a very good antibacterial activity. So I would recommend this technique for root canal obturation whenever you are planning to place a root canal post. Otherwise, if you are doing the full canal obturation and if you are retrieving the gutta percha to create a post space, it might interfere with the apical seal. And one more advantage is, in the same visit itself, if you are doing a sectional obturation, you can place the post and do the core buildup. If you are planning to retrieve the GP after complete root canal obturation, then there are chances that the entire GP might get dislodged and might come with the GG drills or the piezo reamer, which is used for the post space preparation, and it can inadvertently affect the apical seal which is provided by the obturation material. So I would recommend this technique can be considered as a simple, easy to perform and less time consuming technique without any or no other accessory equipments to perform this technique day to day clinical practice, especially whenever you are planning to do a post and core restoration in the same visit. Thank you for watching this video, and I will come with another video soon. Stay tuned. Thank you.